I have another nomad job today that you can do from the road to make some extra money, and this one is for dog lovers. Hey everybody, it's Robin with Creativity RV, and welcome to the third installment in my series on nomad jobs and digital nomad jobs. And I'm excited to tell you guys about this one because I know that we have a lot of dog lovers out there, and this one is perfect if you love to travel and also like to spend time with dogs. I've been on the hunt for you guys, looking for jobs that you can do from the road no matter what your skill set is. And a few months ago, I saw a news article from CNBC, and I'll put the link for that below, about a couple who was traveling the country in a van, and the woman in the couple made her living by walking dogs with Rover.com. Since then, I've been doing some research to give you guys everything you need to know about Rover.com so you can decide if it's something that might work for you to make some money while you're on the road. Rover.com, and I'll put the link for them below as well, does not just do dog walking. They do dog sitting, and they also do house sitting of dogs inside their own house. So it's not like you just have to, you know, grab five dogs and walk them and then go to the next place and walk another bunch of dogs. You can do that, or you can be a house sitter with a dog or dogs in it, or people will pay you to have a drop-in visit where you come to their house and play with their dog and maybe let them out. Every scenario is going to be individual. So let me give you kind of a recap of how Rover works. I've called and I've talked to the company about if this is a good fit for nomads and went through all of the FAQs to get you guys the information that you would need that pertains to nomads. So basically, here's the deal. You have to be 18 or over to work on Rover. You have to be expecting to file your own taxes. You are going to fill out a W-9 if you get your payment by mail. You don't have to do that if you get your payment from PayPal, but I'll tell you about that in a second. And they are going to 1099 you, so you have to be prepared to pay your own taxes. Obviously, you have to love dogs, and you have to be flexible. These are all good things for nomads. In a second here, I'm gonna tell you totally how to apply for Rover, what the steps are, how to set up your profile, and then how you start making money as a nomad. But first, let me tell you what the pros and cons are of this if you're thinking about doing it as a nomad. The downside of working with Rover is that as a nomad, you're not going to get the repeat clientele that other people do when they stay in one city. You're going to have to start over with new dogs and new clients everywhere you go. And you're going to have to be self-motivated. The longer that you're in one place, the more repeat customers you're going to get. So you're not going to get that benefit that the other Rover participants get. Now, of course, what kind of a rig you have as a nomad is going to be a big factor for you. So if you have a big Class A, it might be hard for you to, you know, maneuver to people's houses to walk their dogs. If you have a tow car, that's going to help. If you have a smaller kind of a rig, like a small Class C or a B or a van, this may be more suited for you. So take that into consideration when you're deciding if Rover.com is a good gig for you. But here's the upside. You can do Rover in almost any city. They're in 10,000 cities and Canada. Another upside is that you get to choose your own rate. So you can put a rate out there that's worth your time, and if you don't get the business, great, and if you do, that's great too. So as soon as you're on there and people see that you have some reviews and you've got some testimonials on there, you should be able to jump into a new city and pick up customers right away. Now let me actually walk you through the application and approval process for Rover and then how you can change it to work for you as a nomad. So let me start by saying Rover only accepts about 20% of its applicants. And this is actually a good thing for their brand because, of course, people want trustworthy, friendly people to be inside of their home with their pets. So just know that you have to get through the application process and you have to have a clean background to work for Rover. So here are the steps to actually getting your application in and getting approved. Step number one is you want to go to Rover.com, and again, I'll put the link below. You want to start your profile by selecting Become a Sitter. Now you choose that if you're going to be a house sitter or a dog walker or a play day person, you choose the same thing. Number two, you select Get Started. By the way, Rover has a lot of tips and tutorials that help separate you out so your profile is more attractive to their clients. So you might want to take a look at that while you go through these next steps. An application is going to pop up and you want to fill that out completely. Don't leave anything out or it can delay your process. Then you are going to submit it to the Rover team. You get an email in about 5 days that tells you if you were accepted. So once you're accepted, you go into the Rover marketplace where clients can see you. So take a look up here. I'm going to show you guys a series of actual screenshots from the Rover site of other sitters. Now, they do give you tips like, you know, have a good photo, make sure you get good reviews and testimonials, and make sure that you take care when you fill out your profile so that you're attractive to clients. So what happens when you're in the marketplace is that people can actually see you, like these people right here. Here's an actual screenshot of some people that are on Rover.com selling their services as a dog walker. Or here's another set of people that are putting out their services as a house sitter or a play date person. Now, here's what's cool about Rover. Like I said before, you actually choose your own rate. So the people here that put these rates up, those are their individual rates. And depending on which program you select with Rover, you are going to take home about 75 to 80% of that dollar amount. Now, if you are walking dogs, you know, you're going to have to put the time in. You're going to have to walk a few dogs to make a good amount of money. And I'll also say that I found that rates do vary quite a bit by locale. So after you're approved by Rover, here's how you work it as a nomad. You go back into your profile for whatever city you're going to be visiting, and you change the location of your services based on where you're going to be. So if you're going to be in Phoenix, change it to Phoenix, right? And then I would also take a look at the other people that are there on Rover offering their services and take a look at how much they charge, because there is a big variety of what people charge at Rover.com. But then your profile is going to travel with you. So if you go to one city and you get a good review from somebody and they give you 5 stars, hopefully, then that part of your profile is going to transfer over to your new state with Rover.com. So if you roll into Denver, for example, you go into your profile, you change it to Denver, you look and make sure that your pricing is commensurate with what you want to make and also with what other people are charging in that marketplace. And maybe you do that a few days before you arrive or a day or two before you arrive, depending on what kind of a service you're offering. And then you should start seeing other people in the marketplace that need your services clicking on you, and then you start a conversation. Once you book a gig with a client, their card is actually debited automatically as soon as the booking happens, and it goes into Rover.com. And then 2 days after the service is when Rover.com actually pays you. Now, there are a couple of ways to get paid. Like I said before, you can do it by check, but that doesn't really work for nomads. The other way is through PayPal. So 2 days after you finish the service, you will see a deposit of that money in your PayPal account. So it's very fast and it's all electronic. And so there is no meeting the customer necessarily, and there is no exchange of money. Plus, if they like your service, they can offer tips, which certainly helps out. So you guys, that's it. If you love dogs and you like to walk dogs, or you just want to be a house sitter with a dog, or, you know, while you're going through a town, you just want to be able to pop in to have a play date with a dog, then Rover might be a really good choice for you to make a living or make just some extra money while you're on the road. I hope you guys enjoyed this video. Please do take a minute to stop on your way out and give me a thumbs up. And if other people can use it, please share it. If you haven't subscribed already, please consider doing so. I wish you all happy travels out there, and be free.